We zijn hier in Steyr bij de MAN-fabriek, waar de distributievoertuigen van MAN gemaakt worden, de TGL en de TGM. En we zijn bij de overhandiging van de eerste door MAN gebouwde 9 elektrische trucks aan Oostenrijkse klanten. Een geweldige happening en ook een unieke happening op dit moment.
Very proud to be here today at the handover for the first 9 e-trucks of MAN. We are here together with all our customers, and these trucks will leave the factory in a minute. It was a great party, we had a good time, but now the real project is starting because our customers are taking it for their daily operations into just regular transportation rounds. So for us at MAN, the real project is starting, and now we are collecting the data, mm-hmm. We are optimizing together with the customers, and the exciting time is starting.
How long will you take for collecting data?
The companies will operate these trucks up to 3 years.
Okay.
And so we really have over time the opportunity to optimize based on our common experience, mm-hmm. to optimize data, to work on the efficiency, and it's important to get that because in the testing programs that we have so far, we have of course all our experience in there, but how is the operation now with electric trucks after 1 week, after 2 weeks, after 2 months? Mm-hmm. And that's what we are really looking forward to see that.
And then at that moment you can also say more about the range trucks can drive.
Now, we have already tested these trucks for range, mm-hmm. and the range that we announced today, up to 180 kilometers, is what these trucks are really capable of doing, including the operation that you have with lifting goods, charging and so on, stops, new starting, different routes and so on. Mm-hmm. So that's proven already.
Okay. What are your expectations for improvements of, for example, the batteries in the following 2 or 3 years?
We know what kind of steps the battery technology will take. You know that we engineer the batteries by ourselves. So we have a very deep insight into the modules, the cell technology and so on. And you can expect bigger steps. And of course, in conjunction with that, more range. Please understand that at the moment I cannot tell you how much it will be, but it will be significant more than what we can do today.
Because during the presentation I've heard that it might be 5 to 7 years, maybe 10 years, but there is a possibility that it will be in 5 or 7 years that the range is exactly the same as the diesel trucks drive nowadays.
That's a little bit too easy to say that. When you, for example, take a look at long haul, there are customers and drivers who accomplish more than 600, 700 kilometers per day. And that, from today's point of view, is a true challenge. But if you talk about ranges like national long haul, 300 kilometers, maybe up to 400 kilometers. That is something that, with the technology we have in focus today, shall be achievable. But, you know, that's tomorrow. Let's bring these on the road now and let's prove that this works in the cities and, like I said, for almost up to 200 kilometers.
And now there are 9 customers who will really drive these eTGMs.
Yes.
What kind of distribution do they? What kind of transport?
Yeah, we have basically a couple of groups. We have logistic firms, We have companies that bring groceries towards the cities, and we have a company that also uses it for production part transportation. And you see it in the back here, even we have a cooling box in the back. So we have a cooling box, we have a regular box, we have swap bodies, and we have a 4x2 tractor that allows us really to see in this broad view of applications how the trucks perform. And in a very or comparably short time, we can gain so much experience. And of course, the customers also are very keen now to see how is this working with the drivers. Yeah, we have trained them, they're prepared, they're now really eager to get them rolling. And that's what we'll do in a couple of minutes.
Talking about the drivers, how do they react until now?
I must really say, I haven't seen one that didn't step out of such a truck without a smile on his face. I mean,
causes that smile?
Yeah, when you accelerate, you know, there's no gearbox in here, no shifting, so you have the full torque right from the beginning, and it's very nice to try to see this power that is there, but also to see how silent it is within the truck. And since there's no shifting and rattling and so on, I think that the driving will become more enjoyable. One driver even said, you know, if you have driven this for a week, you do not want to go back into a conventional truck. Yeah. So wow. Excitement is there. But besides all this excitement, of course, we prove also that this technology works.
Interesting. One of the questions that my followers in the Netherlands, of course, will have is when can we expect these eTGMs in our country?
We have an agreement with these first customers that for half a year they can operate it exclusively.
Okay, and so these who are here and who got their keys today.
And of course, that's the most intense time for collecting data, gaining experience. And we want to use this in one step for one further optimization. But then, as announced already today, within 2019, we'll hand over more trucks to customers. And of course, in the Netherlands, you will see them, because the Netherlands are so open for this new technology, and we have seen already many companies adopting to this. And we're looking forward to the customers then using them.
Of course, there are a lot of other initiatives with the other truck brands.
Yes.
What will be the USP for MAN? Why should I, as a transport company, choose for the electric MAN?
Well, we are a big OEM, and we are introducing these trucks now, and you will get our full service support for these vehicles. Wherever we deliver such trucks, the service stations will be prepared, the people will be trained there, and so you have, let's say, our full service. That's one thing. The other thing, maybe more technically, is that within these trucks you will get our own batteries. Yes, we are not producing cells, but we are producing and developing these battery packs ourselves. And there we see really a point where we will differentiate ourselves from others, because the time they will last, the performance they will provide, is something that you will not be able to buy from a shelf. And it was also a strategic decision for us not to take technology from the shelf, because everybody can do that. Then your question is right. If we would have done that, how would we differentiate? And that's the key point for us.
That's quite brave.
Yeah, we have a very deep insight into the battery technology, into the cell technology. And battery management and vehicle energy management is really key for the overall performance of the truck.
And then we are back to what's happening today. Now you're going to collect the data to improve it.
Yes.
And to improve it yourself.
Exactly. And you know, we have the summer now behind us. Fall is coming, winter is coming. So through
heavy weather conditions.
Yes. Yes. And we'll monitor all that on a daily basis and review it. and that will give us, in addition to the testing program we have already conducted, more information than to optimize the parameters that we have now set up with our software that we have inside, and to get it even on a different level, on a higher level, which our customers expect. If you buy an MAN, you expect quality, and that's what you get.
Thank you so much.
My pleasure.
And good luck.
Yeah.
With all the testing.
Thank you.
We bouwen hier twee typen voertuigen. Het ene is de distributie, type 2, 18 ton, 460 pk, tasdistributie, elektrisch, volledig elektrisch, wielbasis 3,80 meter, accupakket zit tussen de langsliggers. Rondom luchtgeveerd en daarmee ook een lage schotelhoogte en een goed rijcomfort. En de andere variant is een 6x2 26 ton, rondom luchtgeveerde bakwagen met een gestuurde nalepas, dus daarmee heel wendbaar voor de binnenstad en ook een hoog laadvermogen. Dat zijn de twee modellen die wij hier in Steyr bouwen op elektrische tractie.
We krijgen nu de kans om de fabriek te bezoeken hier in Steyr, waar onder andere de TGM dus geproduceerd wordt. We lopen nu in de fabriek en het is 4:25 waar de trucks geassembleerd worden. Ik weet niet of ik te verstaan ben. Ik hoor intussen in het Duits de rondleiding. En leuk om hier eens een kijkje te nemen. We'll be right back.